My name is Lesléa Newman, and I'm going to read you a book that I wrote called Remembering Ethan. The book was illustrated by Tracy Nishimura Bishop, and it was published by Imagination Press, which is the children's imprint of the American Psychological Association. Before I read the book, I'm just going to say a few things about it. It is a sad book because it's about a family who has suffered a loss. This is Sarah. And this is her cat, Buttons. And Sarah's big brother, Ethan, has died. So Sarah and her mom and her dad are very sad, of course. So let's see how they express their sadness and how they pull together as a family to remember Ethan. My big brother, Ethan, was so tall he had to duck his head when he walked through the front door. My big brother, Ethan, was so handsome somebody once thought he was a movie star and asked him for his autograph. My big brother Ethan was so strong he could carry me under one arm and Buttons under the other arm, just like we were two big bags of groceries. But that was before Ethan went away. That was before Ethan died. Mommy won't talk about Ethan. As soon as I say his name, she says, "Sarah, don't," and turns her head away. Daddy won't talk about Ethan either. As soon as I say his name, he says, "Sarah, please," and folds his arm and sighs. Buttons is the only one who misses Ethan as much as I do. Buttons carries one of Ethan's socks around in her mouth and kneads it with her paws. Buttons sleeps curled up in a circle on Ethan's bed with her whiskers resting on her tail. Sometimes I sleep there too. This morning, Mommy was standing at the stove cooking breakfast. "Do you want your eggs scrambled or fried?" she asked. I said, "I want them funny side up," like Ethan used to say. Mommy smacked her egg against the side of the frying pan so hard the egg shattered into 100 pieces and dripped all over the floor. I ran upstairs to Ethan's room. Buttons was sleeping on his bed, all curled up in a circle with her whiskers resting on her tail. "I miss Ethan," I told Buttons. I hadn't said his name aloud in a long time. "Ethan, Ethan, Ethan." I sat down at Ethan's desk and took out some markers and paper. I wrote Ethan's name in all capital letters. I wrote Ethan's name in all small letters. I wrote Ethan's name in yellow, blue, orange, red, and green. When I finished writing, I took out a new piece of paper and drew a picture of Ethan giving Buttons and me a double piggyback ride. I carried my picture into the kitchen and hung it up on the refrigerator. When Mommy saw what I had drawn, she burst into tears and ran upstairs. Daddy stood up so fast his chair crashed to the floor, and he ran upstairs too. I stomped back up to Ethan's room. "Doesn't anyone but Buttons and me miss Ethan?" I yelled as loudly as I could. "Doesn't anybody but Buttons and me even remember Ethan?" I yelled even louder. Then I slammed the door, lay down on Ethan's bed next to Buttons, and pulled the cover over my head. A little while later, I came downstairs and found Mommy and Daddy sitting on the living room couch. My picture of Ethan was hanging on the wall right over the fireplace. "Are you still mad at me?" I asked. "We were never mad at you," said Daddy. "We were just too hurt to talk about Ethan yet. I love your picture." "It's beautiful," Mommy said. "I'm glad you drew it. It will help us remember Ethan." Hearing Daddy and Mommy say my big brother's name out loud made me feel happy and sad at the same time. "Come here, Sarah," Mommy said. I sat down between her and Daddy. There was a big book on the coffee table. "What's that?" I asked. "Why don't you open it and see?" answered Daddy. I opened the book. "Look, Sarah," Mommy pointed. "There's Ethan holding you the very first day he became a big brother." "Look, Sarah," Daddy pointed. "There's Ethan lighting candles on a birthday cake he baked just for you." He'd always say, "Want to cut a rug?" Mommy remembered, and then he'd take my hand and twirl me around the room until I was out of breath and laughing. He'd always say, "I challenge you to a duel," Daddy remembered, and then we'd roll up our sleeves and go at it until I gave in and cried, "Uncle!" He'd always say, "Anyone want a horse around?" I remembered, and then I'd put my arms around his neck and say, "Giddy up," and he'd whinny. And we'd ride away. We sat there a while longer remembering Ethan. I curled against Mommy and rested my head on her shoulder. Daddy held my hand. Buttons came downstairs with Ethan's sock in her mouth and jumped into my lap. She was remembering too. Mommy wiped her eyes, Daddy blew his nose, buttons purred, my stomach growled. "Who wants breakfast?" Mommy asked. "I do," I said. "I do," said Daddy. While Mommy cooked, I helped Daddy set the table. Then the three of us sat down and ate our eggs, funny side up, just the way my big brother Ethan liked them. You see the funny side up eggs? So that's the end of my story. And what did Sarah and her mom and dad learn? They learned that they have a lot of happy memories about Ethan, and even though he's no longer with them, they'll always have those happy memories. And talking about Ethan and all the good times they shared makes them feel a little better and brings them closer to one another. So that is my book, Remembering Ethan, and I thank you very much for listening to the story.